Question from Zulhisham. Does the length of jib included as length of boom?
Yes, inside this load chart, there is a different load chart for the lifting using the jib. If you want to use a jib, there is a jib for load chart. And normally for load chart, it doesn't go for the boom length because each jib, for example, is different. For example, of one mobile crane. This is the jib, whether it is an extension or jib or offset. This one is offset because they got this set angle. Set jib. Here, got this. Set the load chart. The load chart for this crane, panel crane, come up with this angle. Normally, it will be bigger angle because you put it as a low angle, going to create length. The radius on one. On this radius, you can know what is the load can be set based on the load chart. The more the less angle will be the more radius, which is bigger. What can be happen here is to overload, you leave on the level overload, can be break here. If the angle too big, and you're using, if it is overload, it can be here, it can be crack or
how a crane operator determine the boom length for radius?
Determine meaning want to set it up. Okay, first before you do lifting, you have to come up with the lifting plan. You go to the side of the set condition. What is the maximum radius that can be lifted? What is the maximum lifting radius that can be set, and what is the load based on that radius? Normally, the most safer way is you have the less radius, because it's going to be much.
So,
do you determine
boom length?
Okay.
Longer better or shorter better?
Shorter better. But if you have a shorter boom length, you have the less radius.
Yes.
And the plan is you have to know what is the radius first, and then you can set what is the
boom
the boom that need to be. Okay. One good question. Okay, you already identified your radius. You want to be this kind of radius. Okay. You have few options. Okay. You can have this shorter.
Short.
You have can this
longer,
and you have
this longest
A, B, and C. Yeah. The same radius.
Yes.
Which one is better?
Okay.
This will be the maximum radius. Okay. The better is depends on this angle radius. If it is too short or too low the radius, it can be tilted.
The angle.
Yeah. The lower angle.
Lower angle
can be tilted. Even though that is very short boom. Okay. The longer, it can be bended. Okay. It's stronger, but the boom will be, if you look at this free body diagram, okay, you've got this load, force here, and you've got some moment on the, so it can be bent. And if you ask some of the crane operator, if they are using longer boom, they can see from below, it is being bent.
Like fishing boom.
Yes, like a fishing rod.
The fishing rod.
The complication that to happen is because this boom, they got docks, they got section, and it is been extended by using hydraulic. If the boom is been bended, and then you move the you close up this boom, it's going to be extra pressure on the hose. And normally, hose and the hydraulic pump will burst. It will be impact on the hydraulic, because all this movement is being controlled by hydraulic.
So that means, when possible, B is the best option.
B is the best. Depends on the radius, depends on the load.
And also work condition.
Yeah.
So B will be the most preferred.
And also on this boom rack, it can only be extended evenly. It cannot be like only small. Must be
same length for each section.
Yes, same length for each section. So the load will be distributed evenly. It can be set up inside the crane cabin. Azman Shah, okay. Assalamualaikum tuan, maaf terlepas dari awal. Cuma nak tanya, jika jeep yang datang berasingan dengan crane, apakah sertifikat atau dokumen yang kita perlu kita minta dari crane provider? First sekali, crane manual. Sebab dalam crane manual, dia akan spesifik. Dia akan beritahu what kind of jeep, berapa size dia, what kind of load, berapa load dia. And have to make sure juga dia tak menggunakan crane yang lain. Normally bila benda ni datang basingan, dia menggunakan crane yang lain. As long as ada dalam crane manual, you can use.
Okay. So means kalau Komatsu, contoh macam Tadano, jeepnya pun Tadano lah.
Yes.
Tak boleh tiba-tiba dia benda Tadano pakai Kone.
Tak boleh. Dia specific dia punya tu lah. Dia punya jeep
manufacturer.
Otherwise dia mungkin boleh pasang, mungkin tak jadi apa-apa, tapi benda tu salah. Kalau jadi apa-apa, if something happen, it is not being covered by insurance.
Ada tak universal jeep?
Universal jeep, no such thing. It must be specific with the crane.
Biasanya.
But universal spreader bar, yes. There is a spreader bar. Spreader bar is not the lifting equipment. It's a lifting accessories. Itu balik. Lifting accessories is not lifting equipment.
Ada lagi
soalan?
Ada lagi soalan.
Dah berdatas.
Sementara
length of jeep include the length of boom? Yes, correct. Okay, but on the specific lochat, jeep lochat. Sedikit iklan, lifting planner course. Okay, 19 Januari buat di sini, bagus tempat ni.
Promote sikit, promote kan lifting planner.
Okay, trainer dia daripada Encik Zahal. Alright, tak ada apa soalan. Just a little bit promotion. First on the baju dulu. Baju kerabat Melayu. Maksud-maksud tadi Encik Azhan cakap cantik baju. Kita set design dia. Daripada tanah Melayu. Okay. Can get it from tanah Melayu. Tengok Facebook lah, tanah Melayu. M-Shaw's currently on this promotion for M-Shaw's audit. M-Shaw's what? So any organization, you are most welcome. to join, to participate in Ramshaw's Ward, you can visit our website www.mshaws.yg.my, specific on the Ramshaw's Ward 2019. And also Ramshaw's also looking for
auditors.
Any professional or any HSE practitioner that can fulfill the requirement of being auditors, you can also participate. You can also register yourself in this as an auditor. You can visit our website www.mshaws.org.my to become one of the auditors. It's a good exposure. It's a good experience. So join us.
Yeah. Especially to those safety men, you've been following us for a long time. I strongly recommend you to participate in this MSOSH award, because why? This is where the value of safety is appreciated. Appreciated. At least you have the chance to have luncheon with minister. With minister, and then to recognize your efforts. Not only you, with your team, with your management, this is the easiest practical way to participate. It's not expensive, right? Like RM2,000 fee?
Depends on the
organization size. It's affordable. You don't have any bad excuses not to participate.
Yeah.
You should participate. And as auditors, I myself is an auditor. And in Johor, we have very limited auditor. So, if you have already lead auditor certificate,
yep,
you have experience doing audit, your organization is implementing the system, please come, join us. And the benefit is we can observe other people's practices, which is very, very precious experience. Mm. Last year, I missed his place. Somehow! I don't know why. So, yeah, please join. And last thing before we say goodbye, lifting planner course, 19 January. One day session, you will learn how to plan your manpower, calculate your load chart, your lifting loads, and then generate the lifting plan. Again, the intention is to pass on the knowledge to you so that your lifting operations can be performed safely. That's it. Okay, HRDF claimable, CEP 5-point. If that is not enough reason to join lah. Okay. So again, thank you, Arif. Thank you for sharing. We learn a lot. Right. Hopefully we will continue to call you. Okay. So see you. Tomanilah and be safe. Azahan, safety man.
Assalamualaikum.